Need to spruce up a boring floor? Well, Homefront has the tips in half an hour here on BBC Two after Looking Good.
Welcome to Looking Good, the style programme that's on your side. On tonight's show, handbags. Little is big on the catwalk, but could you cope with a bag the size of a cigarette packet? Say goodbye to your cellulite. We test out beauty salon slimming treatments. And Jill Dando's top tips for what to pack for a weekend away. Did you know that the British man spends, on average, just £250 a year on clothes? It's a wonder the shell suit ever went out of fashion. Still, if he thinks it's clever to be tight-fisted, he might not feel so smug if he realised that not spending money on clothes could, career-wise, be costing him dear. Well, that's what the Menswear Council think. Their new campaign, Dress for Success, aims to get men into the shops.
I think a lot of men know that if they dress well at work, then they're going to be successful. We all know that an interview is decided within the first 30 to 60 seconds. And that has got nothing to do with the MBA or the degree or whatever you might have, and everything to do with the way that you're presenting yourself.
So it's all down to your clothes. What you wear can mean success or failure. Really, we found two Looking Good viewers with very different attitudes.
Certainly never go out and buy a suit. I'd never go and buy a suit for a wedding. In fact, I've never had a suit in my life. The only suit I've got is a tracksuit.
At work, it's always shirt and ties and suit. Always has been, always will be.
Steve Lister runs his own successful computer software company. He has a suit for every day of the month. So what does this say about him?
He's obviously thinking through what he's going to wear today, picking out various alternatives. So he's thinking carefully about what his day involves and what he's going to need for that day. He's laying out a number of ties, so that's consistent with that again. Everything seems to fit. The lifestyle at the home, the car, the clothes, all match together.
If I'm sitting and having a board meeting, it definitely wouldn't be appropriate if I was walking in jeans and a t-shirt. And on the sales side, if I'm going to see clients, it definitely wouldn't be appropriate if I was going in less than a shirt and tie. Obviously, if I look after myself, I'm smart and presentable. I mean, obviously, my company's that way as well.
Jeremy Skinner, on the other hand, thinks dressing up for work is a total waste of time.
Jeremy already is an unusual character in the sense that he's got long hair, he's got a goatee. He's slightly unconventional in that regard. He doesn't, unlike Steve, have suits. It's all casual gear. Given that he's a kind of civil servant and doesn't deal in most of his daily work with the public or with clients or with customers, then it's perfectly all right to wear that. That's kind of consistent. But we'd have to take a look at his office to decide whether that was consistent with what other people wear.
I don't really know if there's anything you couldn't wear. There are probably certain things that they'd frown on.
I know.
It's never been an issue. Nobody's ever had to turn around and say, you know, can you just come a bit smarter? It just doesn't occur to me what other people think. Whether I wear a suit or whether I wear rags, I can still do the job just as well.
Sunday, Monday, happy days.
We thought we'd test Jeremy's theory by getting him to dress like Steve for a week. And naturally, in the name of science, Steve agreed to dress, well, like Jeremy.
Right, let's just take a little look what they've sent me. This is day one's clothes. This'll be fun. Tracksuit bottoms. That's what I wear to get up in the morning on the weekends. A denim jacket. Oh dear, don't think that's for me.
Thank you.
Well, white shirt, you can't go too wrong there.
The tie's not bad either. Yeah, and the jacket's quite nice as well. It's not something I'd wear myself, but I said I'll do it, so I'll give it a go. Here it is. It's not as bad as I thought it'd be. You know, I do like it. I like the style of the suit, I like the cut of it. I think I look really smart. I feel too overdressed for work. But nevertheless, it's nice. I'm pleased with it. Working 9 to 5, what a way to make a living, barely getting by. It's all taking and no giving. They just use your mind and they never give you credit. It's enough that drive you crazy if you let it. 9 to 5.
So, Jen, what do you think?
Shocking.
You look really nice.
Very smart.
Yeah, very smart, very professional. Well, it's approaching the end of day one and everybody's quite keen on the idea of me in a suit. I find that a bit disconcerting.
Day one. Started off bad. I feel like I've just got out of bed. I've got a pair of trainers, tracksuit bottoms and just a t-shirt on. Bit of a difficult one really, it was just an off-spec visit. I thought I'd just drop in and see someone. Didn't even get past the receptionist, so a bit embarrassing really, a bit embarrassing.
Smith, what do you reckon?
Didn't recognise you there.
Oh, what brings you here?
Just on holiday, are we?
It was nice to feel smart, but, you know, day one, let's see what we feel like at the end of the week. Another day, another outfit.
Oh, no.
Is it me? I think so.
Oh, my goodness.
Hello, Jeremy, I like that one. It looks pretty good.
OK, Deborah. Thanks very much indeed. Okay, bye-bye. That was good that she didn't see me.
Yesterday's was alright, but I really love this one.
The linen is really, really nice. Yeah. Coming Tuesday,
I feel better. This is more Jamie Theakston than Steve Lister.
I'm going to get stopped. Someone thinks I've nicked the car.
No, it's not been too bad. But I think if I was to wear that to work to dress for success, I'd have to be fired. Got to be honest.
I don't like it on you. The colour don't suit you at all.
Good, because I hate it as well.
Another pass for you, sir.
Thank you.
What does Lindsay think of what I'm wearing?
Well, it's not quite as bad as some of the things you've had to wear, but it's still bad enough to go to the office in.
Mm. Last day, it's been a very difficult week. Got quite an important business meeting in a couple of minutes. I'm going to go and change. I think I'm going to go and put my suit on for it. I feel a bit embarrassed in what I'm wearing. I don't think it's quite appropriate for the meeting that I've got.
But I've had a good time doing it. Thanks, BBC.
If you're the kind of person who needs a Sherpa to carry her bags, even though you're only going away for the weekend, help is at hand from the much-travelled Jill Dando.
I don't get it right. I never get it right. I'm the sort of person, I'm afraid, who always takes far more than I need. But I have this suitcase here, and it's a lot smaller than I normally take. But we have to be disciplined. Now, it is difficult if you're a woman to be economical with clothes when you're going somewhere like Paris or Rome. But you have to be. A good jacket, nice jacket that'll go with most things. And so, pair of jeans. You always need a nice, smart pair of jeans and a smarter, perhaps a lighter pair of trousers as well. You see, they all go together. A couple of neutral blouses, I suppose. There's a nice jumper there. Perhaps a short sleeve one as well. In the evening, you want to dress up a bit. How about this nice little velvet number?
A mix and match wardrobe in neutral colours, which make an assortment of outfits and can be layered depending on the weather.
You need smart shoes for the evening. Maybe a couple of pairs of shoes, really, for a weekend. And these plimsolls, they'll take.